Dear friends, welcome back. In this video, we take a first look at the popular Raspberry Pi board and then we learn how to boot it. Let's start. The Raspberry Pi is an impressive platform. The model I have in front of me is a Raspberry Pi A Plus model, which was sent to me by GearBest.com. I chose the model A Plus instead of the more powerful ones because this board is ideal for embedded projects that require low power consumption. Let's see what this board has to offer. The Raspberry Pi Model A Plus is very small in size. It has the same size as the Arduino Uno, but don't be fooled by its small size. This board is extremely powerful. It has the same computational power of a laptop that you could buy 10 years ago. It uses a 700 MHz 32-bit processor. It has 256 MB of RAM memory. It runs Linux as an operating system and all that with a price tag of $30. It is really impressive. The board also has a full-size HDMI slot, a display port, this one here, a camera port, an integrated audio and video jack, 40 GPIO pins and a USB 2 port. Also, in the front we can find a micro USB connector in order to provide power to the Raspberry Pi A+. The power consumption of this board can be as low as only 1 watt. That ultra-low power consumption makes this board ideal for battery-powered embedded projects that require huge processing power. The board on the back has only one micro SD card. Now, let's see how to boot this device for the first time. In order to boot the device, we need a micro SD card with a capacity of at least 4 GB. We then have to copy a Linux distribution in the card. Let's go to the computer in order to do it. In order to download the Linux distribution that we need, we go to the official Raspberry Pi website. We then go to Downloads. And we download the noobs offline install file. We download it and we save it. It is a big file and it will take us about 10 to 20 minutes to download. Let's wait. When the download is complete, we unzip the file inside the SD card module. The extraction will take some time. Now that the extraction is complete, we can remove the SD card from the computer and insert it in the Raspberry Pi. Now we are ready to connect the Raspberry Pi to a television or a monitor. Let's do it. First, I connect a USB hub to Raspberry Pi in order to have more USB ports available in order to connect Wi-Fi, keyboard and mouse. I have powered on the board using a standard cell phone charger. The input voltage of the Raspberry Pi is 5 volts. Any 5-volt adapter that can provide 500 milliamps will do. At first, the device asks us what we want to install. We select the Raspbian distribution and we press OK. My wireless mouse and keyboard were recognized at once. Impressive. After 10 to 15 minutes, the installation is complete. Now we have the option to either boot with a graphical interface or with a command line. I choose the graphical interface and I reboot. After a couple of minutes, the graphical interface is loaded. As you can see, it is a fully capable small computer. It recognized my external Wi-Fi dongle at once, so I can browse to the internet. I can play games such as Minecraft or program using Scratch or other software. I have to say that I am truly impressed. This thing is so easy. As I mentioned earlier, there are more powerful Raspberry Pi models out there, such as the Raspberry Pi 2, which you can use as a small computer. The A+ model we use today is kind of slow to act as a computer, but it is great for embedded projects. The power consumption of the board is just over 1 watt when we are connected to the internet via Wi-Fi and we use a keyboard and a mouse, but it is reduced to less than 1 watt if we don't use any of these peripherals. The power consumption is very low for such a capable device and as you can see, I am now powering it from a small power bank using 4 AA batteries.
The batteries have a capacity of 2500 mAh, so the Raspberry Pi can stay on for around 12 hours.
As we saw, the Raspberry Pi is an impressive little device. With it, we can build more advanced projects than the ones we were building so far, so stay tuned. If you want to buy this board, please consider doing it from gearbest.com, which was kind enough to send me a sample unit in order to build projects with it for our channel. Gearbest.com also offers a coupon code to all the viewers of our channel, so you can get the Raspberry Pi A Plus for only $25 free shipping. Just enter this code at checkout. You can find a link for the board in the description of the video. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post do-it-yourself hardware and software projects every Saturday. I hope that you liked this video, and I will see you next week.